We've got all the ceiling done. We did the walkout wall. We sealed that. We did the floor to wall joint, which is what all that orange foam is. We did all the control joints. We did over under the steps. Did along all the load bearing walls. The joint there. And then where the stringers got go down under the steps, there's often an opening to the soil, so we foamed all that up. We did all the plumbing penetrations. So everything's sealed that we can get at. So sealing edges like that, or plumbing penetrations. So now, we've got that flow tube hooked up again, or pitot tube, with our shop vac sucking on it. We've got it dampered down to just what I want to suck. And you can see that we're reaching everything now. Our target's about 5 pascals negative in our furthest, weakest test hole, which is over around the corner by the stairs. So, with this pitot tube, we can calculate how much air we're moving. We're moving about 11 CFM. That's what our radon system has to be capable of. And you can see before, when I had that pitot tube wide open, before we sealed, we were moving 90 CFM. So, we only need 11. So about 80 of that CFM that we were pulling, or probably even more than that, was coming from the house. So if we wouldn't have sealed that, there would have been a huge energy penalty, and we would have had a much bigger radon fan, which would have used a lot more energy. So now I'll just open this damper up, because this is choking our simulation down. And we'll see what that does to our numbers. So we're just over 5 pascals there. And now you can see, throwing that much air at it would be overkill, which would be a more expensive fan, using more energy. So that just goes to show the importance of sealing. The key to getting your levels low is to get vacuum under the entire slab, and sealing gaps and cracks really helps allow us to accomplish that. Thank you.